So there seems to be this fear that there's a right way to do something and a wrong way to do something. And if we're not doing something the perceived right way, then we're in the wrong. And being in the wrong has consequences, right? Depending upon the venture that you are undertaking and your goal. Being in the wrong could mean less success, less financial dividends, could even mean being ostracized in society or committing social suicide, so to speak. So doing things the wrong way definitely has consequences in our society, or the perceived wrong way. And we as human beings constantly live in fear of not doing things correctly, and therefore not being able to benefit or gain the rewards of doing things correctly. And that's where, for me, this BookTube consumerism discussion really stems from, because we have those who are afraid that they're not BookTubing correctly. You know, if I'm not buying all these books and have this huge book collection and film my videos in front of these beautifully decorated white shelves with fairy lights and twinkle lights and decor and all these beautiful books nicely displayed, then I'm BookTubing wrong. Then I'm a failure and I'm going about this venture the wrong way. And there seems to be all this pressure to buy more books, haul more books, you know, film in front of a bookshelf, and even though you may not even be able to afford it, somehow scrounge up enough change to not only support this book buying habit that you may or may not even desire to truly support, but also purchase these shelves to display these books on in order to film in front of them, in order to then be doing things the right way and to be successful. So with these BookTube consumerism discussions, I feel that the seed of it all is that fear of doing things wrong, that fear of others looking at you and finding you lacking, finding you not good enough, finding you less than, you know, someone else. That fear of not fitting in to the community, that fear of not being able to be as successful as those that perhaps you watch and admire and, you know, perhaps even aspire to reach the heights of BookTube success as they have. So that is, for me, what the seed and the root of this all is. You know, you have a lot of people talking about the guilt that comes with their book buying habits, and I feel that self-awareness is crucial. Where is that guilt coming from, and why is that guilt being felt? Is it a guilt because you're being financially irresponsible? Is it a guilt because you are feeling like you are becoming overly materialistic and you don't feel that your priorities are in order? Is it guilt because somewhere deep down inside you feel that buying books is wrong, or buying the amount of books that you're buying is wrong? And therefore you really have to sit with yourself and dig down deep and sort of become self-aware as to what your book buying habits are and why your book buying habits are the way they are. We have a lot of people who use buying books, buying anything in general, sort of as therapy, right? They call it retail therapy for a reason. And when they're having a bad day, or they're feeling low, or their mental health is not the best, they like to buy books to make themselves feel better. And in a way that's very similar to binge eating, you know, there's the guilt that comes after that. And so there's a self-awareness that needs to happen, you know, to dig deep to figure out if this is healthy or not, if this is a habit that is sustainable, if this is a habit that is truly something that will benefit you to continue. If your finances are struggling and are basically in jeopardy because your priorities are off and you're spending an exorbitant amount of money buying books, then that's also something that needs to be examined. So there's a lot of self-reflection and self-awareness that needs to happen. There is a lot of honesty that needs to happen. I feel that we all need to be honest with ourselves, because those of us who sit at home and watch others show off the books they have, whether they be, you know, in the background with beautiful shelves or through book hauls or whatever the case may be, those of us that are sitting at home and feeling some type of way about kind of looking at this and seeing this, you kind of have to ask yourself, why? Is it jealousy? Is it pride? Is it because you are judgmental? Are you having a bad day? Because at the end of the day, it's not up to me to question someone else on how they're spending their money, you know? We have to stop policing one another's pockets, and we have to stop this idea that there's a right way to do this and a wrong way to do this. It doesn't matter if you have 5,000 books or if you own 4 books or if you own no books. It doesn't matter if you believe in only exclusively getting books from the library and you do not believe in having a book collection. And it doesn't matter if you have an entire library in your home filled to the brim, you know, floor to ceiling shelves of books that you've bought over the years and that you will continue to buy, whether you're buying books every week, every month, every day. It honestly doesn't matter what other people think, as long as you are content and happy with your own book buying habits, as long as those habits are healthy and you've examined them for yourself and you have enough self-awareness to know why you are doing what you're doing and if it is going to be able to be sustainable, both financially, emotionally, mentally, and physically. If you are running out of room in your home and you're living like a hoarder, then that's something to think about. If you're going broke, then that's something to think about. If you buying books is something that you're doing to fill a void inside of you, whether it be an emotional or spiritual void, and actually you feel very guilty after buying books, and that's something to think about. You know, there's so many factors that go into it, and not just the financial aspect, because that's a lot of what I've seen is, you know, it's none of your business what I choose to do with my money, and why are you judging me for spending money on books? And that is all well and good and very true. I do believe that 2019 definitely needs to be a year of people minding their own business and not policing other people's pockets and wallets and salaries. You know, you have to allow people to do what they do. But speaking to us as the consumer, you have to examine your own habits and make sure that they are healthy and sustainable for your lifestyle, you know, and also you have to do what makes you the happiest and the most content, and you kind of have to mute out the outside voices and mute out the outside noise and kind of dig deep and, like I said, become self-aware about yourself and what you're doing and make sure that it's something that is good for you, good for your soul, good for your environment, good for your lifestyle. So many things go into play with BookTube consumerism and consumerism when it comes to buying books in general. Another important thing I want to touch on is that we all have habits. You know, just because someone is a book collector and buys books all the time, and perhaps you look at that individual as being irresponsible or wasting their funds, or, you know, you're kind of judging this individual for buying so many books. Well, you know, everyone has habits and buying habits, and, you know, everyone has that thing that they spend their money on. You have people who spend lots of money on makeup and they have huge makeup collections. You have people who spend money on shoes and, you know, their closets are bursting with shoes. You have people who are obsessed with fashion, people who spend their money on jewelry, you know, collecting watches and bracelets and all sorts of other adornments. You have people who are very obsessed with food and they consider themselves to be food connoisseurs, and they're spending thousands and hundreds of dollars going to new restaurants and going to food festivals and checking out different cuisine and just having so much fun being foodies, and that's where their money is going. You have people who are film critics on the low and they love going to the movies and they spend all their money going to indie films and theaters and really enjoying that cinematic experience. You have those who are obsessed with the theater, those who love going to museums, those who spend their money traveling all over the world. So really, it's all about where you put your money and where you want to put your money. So I feel that as if it is wrong to judge someone for spending a lot of money on books when you need to look at yourself and see where all of your money is going. Okay, so maybe you don't have a large book collection, you don't spend a lot of money on books, but you're spending a lot of money somewhere else, and it's very hypocritical to point the finger at someone else and be judgmental about their spending habits and where they're spending what you feel is the majority of their funds, when there's definitely an area of your life that is where you spend the majority of your funds as well, or at least a large amount. Another thing to take into consideration is the support of the publishing industry. Honestly, I don't see anything wrong in buying books in bulk or in having a large book collection, especially because as a writer, I feel it's so important to support the traditional publishing industry, to support publishing houses, and to make sure that authors will continue to make a living writing books and that publishing houses will continue to exist and pump out actual physical copies of books. I think there is nothing more amazing than spending your money in an industry that you believe in and an industry that you want to have a future, that you want to see continue to where your children and your children's children and their children can continue to enjoy it as well, because we're supporting it with our hard-earned coin. I don't see anything wrong with that, and I feel like that is an angle that has been missed in a lot of these videos. I don't see why we want to condemn someone for putting their money into an industry that is so valuable and is so enjoyable, like the book publishing industry, that allows us to have these amazing stories in paper form where we can definitely escape and have all of these amazing adventures. Yes, okay, there are those that solely use the library, but the library are still filled with books that came from the publishing industry. And without the publishing industry thriving and being healthy and being able to employ new writers and give voice and give an opportunity to writers to get their stories out there, there would be no libraries. Our libraries would be empty. So I think that's another angle of this that's important, is supporting the publishing industry and definitely putting your money where your mouth is. You say you love books and you love reading and you love your favorite authors and you want to support them. Well, why not support them with your money? It's kind of like the music industry. You can love your favorite artist all day, but if you're pirating their albums and you're only streaming their albums and you're not supporting them by buying their albums and buying a physical copy, not just digital, and going to their shows and spending your money and kind of putting your money where your mouth is and putting the financial backing behind, you know, that passion and love you have for that artist, then what is the point? I feel the same way about the publishing industry. You say, like I said, that you are obsessed with books and reading and that you're a bookish person and this is a hobby and a passion, or maybe you're even a writer and you are hoping to be published yourself one day. I feel that it is very odd for you not to put your money behind that. Sorry if this video is all over the place and I'm rambling. I just wanted to get all my thoughts out and they're just kind of pouring out, so sorry. At the end of the day, I find it really interesting that we, those of us in this bookish community who profess to be readers and lovers of words and stories, you know, we have been trained, our brains have been molded to really seek and empathize with other people, because that's what reading is. When you read a book, you really put yourself in the shoes of someone else, of a character or many characters, in order to see the world through their eyes and really understand where they're coming from, understand their motivation, understand their journey, and to really see why they do the things that they do. Reading teaches us to be empathetic human beings and to have compassion and understanding for those around us. I deeply believe that being a reader has made me a better person, because it has really opened my eyes to the different life experiences that others are living all around me, and that everyone is fighting a different battle and has taught me kindness and compassion. So I find it interesting that in a hobby that has taught us so many pure and beautiful things about how to connect with one another and how to truly empathize with one another and how to kind of give each other a break and extend grace, right, to one another. So we have this hobby that has given us all of this, and yet we are so quick to judge one another. We are so quick to point the finger. We are so quick to kind of police one another's pockets. And we are so quick to build this blueprint of what it looks like to be a perfect BookTuber, you know, filming in front of these beautiful shelves. Or, you know, some of us feel being the perfect BookTuber is exclusively using the library and not owning any books or owning as few books as possible. Hashtag minimalism. So I find it very interesting that, you know, we are the part of the population that should be the most empathetic, the most compassionate, the kindest, the most understanding, because of what reading has taught us and how it has opened our eyes to the battles that the people around us are fighting each and every single day. And I find it sad that we who should be the kindest, we who should be the most understanding and should extend the most grace and empathy to our fellow man, instead can be the most judgmental and can be our own harshest critics and the harshest critics of each other. It's so sad, and I definitely think that that needs to change, and that comes with, like I said earlier, just being self-aware and understanding our own book buying habits and not judging others on theirs. At the end of the day, it's a live and let live type of thing. You don't want to police other people's pockets and judge people for what they're doing with their own money that has nothing to do with you and your life, and you also do not want to place people in the things that they do when it comes to their book buying habits. The day, I think we all just need to be a little bit kinder to one another. I think that we all just need to take a step back and remember to extend grace and to be understanding. We need to take the content creators on this platform, in this little corner of our little YouTube sphere, that these content creators are pouring their hearts and souls into giving us this content, and whether they film in front of beautiful bookshelves or in front of a tapestry like I do, whether they own thousands of books or just four or none at all, whether they exclusively believe in only using the library or they believe in buying five books a day, I think what's most important is that we continue to just really appreciate the content that our favorite creators are putting out, that we continue to support one another, uplift one another, that we are really just full, that the reasons behind what we do is not always clear, that what we show and what we put out there is only a teeny little bit of part of our own story, and that we all have a reason for doing what we do. Y'all just need to mind our own damn business. Like, is it that hard? Just mind your business. It's not your business what I'm doing with my money, and it's not your business why I buy as many or as few or no books that I do. Come on. Those are my thoughts on the BookTube consumerism discussion topic that has been floating around here in our community for the past few weeks. It's definitely a discussion that happens every few years, if not every year. And, you know, something always happens is kind of spark it up and bring it up again. And I've always wanted to participate, so I'm glad I'm getting the opportunity to kind of give my thoughts on this one. At the end of the day, I think we all just need to enjoy one another's content, support each other, and mind our own damn business. Okay? 2019, the year of minding your business. Either you watch the haul or you don't. It's very easy to X out at the top of the screen, okay? Alright, that's it for this video. I will catch you all in my next video. Peace! Bye guys, love you. Subscribe, thumbs up, hit the notifications bell. I'm out. Thank you, next to. I've got several books for this one. First one is Zenith. I have a whole video on that, which I will link right now if for some strange reason you haven't seen it yet. Second one is Uglies by Scott Westerfeld. I read that whole book and I was really interested way back when I first joined BookTube on reading that series. There was like some hype.